Captain Glovo's plan to evacuate the civilians aboard his ship has come to a disastrous end. A barrier overload during a fierce battle with the Zentradi has wiped out a nearby Earth city and much of the surrounding countryside. The people of Earth know nothing of the circumstances that led to the explosion, only that the Space Fortress is now regarded as a threat to life and property. The city of Toronto has withdrawn its offer to take in the refugees, and the ship is homeless once again. Meanwhile, Commander-in-Chief Dolza reviews the video record of the battle and is shocked.
Run that video again.
Yes, sir.
These Micronians are more ruthless than I first believed. They were prepared to sacrifice an entire population center simply to defeat four small divisions of attacking pods. I suppose it comes as no surprise to you, Britai, that they possess a weapon of such enormous power and the determination to use it no matter what.
No, sir.
Commander Azonia's inexperience with these beings has proven to be an obvious liability. I'm therefore sending you back to take charge of our forces.
On one condition, Your Lordship. I must request the Imperial-class fleet be redeployed and placed under my command.
Why such a large force?
Because I'll be dealing with an opponent who is unpredictable and potentially explosive. I'll need the extra resources.
Very well then, you have them,
Your Lordship.
That is all.
Yes, sir.
One thing before you leave.
Yes? What?
I expect you to give me better results this time.
You'll not be disappointed with my performance, my lord.
For your sake, I hope not. Commander!
Britai, may I be permitted to know our plans?
Dolza gave me command of the Imperial-class fleet.
That means a million of our ships have been placed at your disposal. He must have something important in mind for you to do.
Yes. He wants me to return to the Micronian star system and take care of our problems before we lose control of the situation completely.
As Britai and Exidor are shuttled back to their ship, it occurs to them that the task they've been reassigned to carry out may well be the most difficult one they have ever faced. Each previous encounter with the Battle Fortress has ended in defeat for the Zentradi war machine.
It could be that we've underestimated them.
You may be right, sir.
Even a million ships may not overcome their defenses. I'll be most anxious to hear what our spies have to report when they return to the ship with their observations. Prepare all vessels for a fold operation immediately and begin a countdown.
All vessels move to fold position. Axis pattern adjust flagship's attitude. Countdown has begun. Hyperspace fold to commence in exactly 1 minute.
Unloading will commence in exactly 1 minute. Please be sure all cargo bay doors are open to receive initial supply consignment from helicopter shuttle room. Upper flight decks should now be clear and convoy vehicles in place to begin supply transfer to warehouse distribution centers.
Ever since the barrier overload and subsequent destruction, rumors have swept through the ship that the Battle Fortress is no longer welcome on Earth. The appearance of supply trucks in the streets does not go unnoticed by civilians and serves to confirm their worst fears. Meanwhile, Rick Hunter writes a letter to Ben Dixon's parents, informing them that their son has died in the line of duty.
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Dixon, as your son's commanding officer, it's my sad duty to inform you that... Oh, I just can't do it! Oh... They were both so proud of him! Oh. There's nothing I can say to make this any easier. It seems like such a waste!
Lieutenant O'Buddy.
Lieutenant O'Buddy.
Ben, is that you?
Hi.
Hi.
I know you're feeling bad, but it couldn't be helped. It was just my time to go.
Lieutenant, are you there? Yeah, I'm here. Huh? Let's go. I need to get some fresh air anyway.
I guess it's tough being in command. I mean, after a while, I guess you start feeling responsible for everybody who's serving under you, right?
I can't begin to tell you how helpless I feel each time we go into battle. It's like watching somebody slip out of your grasp and fall off a cliff. You always wonder if there wasn't something more you could have done to save them.
I wonder if I'll feel that way when I get my first command. It's probably coming soon. They just promoted me to second lieutenant, and it's been barely a month since I was promoted to third lieutenant.
I'm sure you'll make a good commander, Max.
I hope you're right. Hey, get a load of that fancy chopper up there. It must be somebody important.
Must be some big shot. I bet you anything they brought orders for us to go back into space. I understand we haven't been too popular around headquarters.
Huh. So you think it's true about us being banished from Earth?
I'm afraid they pulled in the welcome, Matt. We have no place to live.
I know.
Except for this ship.
This is our home for a long time to come.
Well, then this may be the last time we get to see Earth from the surface. We better enjoy the view while we can.
That's the best advice I've heard all day.
While Rick and Max enjoy their last sunset, deep in the bowels of the great ship, the three Zentradi spies are about to enjoy their last meal before attempting to make their escape.
Hey, you guys! It's ready!
Good! I'm starving! What have we got today?
It's called beef stew.
It smells terrific. Let's eat.
Hey, how about some music? Listening to Min Mei helps my food go down better.
She makes everything better.
What about my cooking, boys? You think it's improved some?
Yeah, it takes me over an hour to get indigestion now.
That is better. It used to take 15 minutes.
When he first started cooking, I used to get sick just thinking about it.
I'm gonna miss this Micronian food.
Well, I hate to admit it, but you're right, me too.
And that's not all. I've been thinking, I'm gonna miss a whole lot of things. Like movies, happy people, music.
Yeah, the music. The thing I'll miss the most is hearing Min Mei sing every day.
Forget about that.
And you remember those girls we met that one time? Yep, dancing was fun.
Yeah, that Kim was really something else. She had me laughing almost all day.
And that girl, Sammy, when she spotted us with the doll. My heavens!
It's hard to believe that by tomorrow morning we'll all be back in uniform.
Yeah, I can hardly wait.
I let headquarters know the orders were received, Captain.
Yes, the orders were received. And you can tell those idiot generals back at headquarters that the orders were received in silence, completely under protest. This is just unbelievable. These men haven't got an ounce of pity in their hearts. What am I supposed to say to the people of this ship when I'm presented with orders like these? The United Earth Council hereby orders you to remove your vessel from any proximity to the Earth. You are also ordered to keep the civilian refugees on board your ship. If these orders are not followed to the letter, we may be forced to...
Captain, may I come in?
Yes.
I beg your pardon. Is something wrong?
Yes, something's wrong. But it's what we expected. We've been ordered to leave the Earth immediately.
Oh. I'll fix you a drink, Captain.
After the implosion accident, I expected the ship to be sent away from the Earth, but to force 70,000 innocent civilians to become refugees from their own planet.
Here you go, Captain.
I guess we should drink a toast to our last moments on Earth.
Perhaps we should drink a toast to the civilians instead.
I think that would be a nice gesture, Lisa.
The civilians, then.
These orders go into effect as soon as we finish loading. That means that we'll be forced to break the news of our banishment to everyone just moments before we take off.
Do you want me to announce it, sir?
No, I'd better make the broadcast myself, Lisa.
I'll make the arrangements immediately.
Bridge Officer Grant speaking.
This is Captain Glofalo. The supplies loaded yet?
You're almost ready now, sir.
Now listen carefully, Bobby. I want you to quietly begin preparations to move out.
What?
Prepare to take off.
Yes, sir. Prepare for takeoff.
You mean to say all those rumors about leaving are true?
Well, let's be realistic. We did wipe out an entire city, you know.
We weren't responsible. That was a barrier overload.
Claudio, what's going to happen to all of the civilians?
Well, since they've already been declared dead, nobody wants to accept them. I guess they'll stay with us. Now hurry up with those final checks. We're running out of time.
Lisa's father's a big shot in the United Earth government. Maybe if she sent him a message, he'd hold up our orders until we... Oh!
Don't you dare suggest such a thing to Lisa. She's in enough trouble with her father. Now get busy.
While the SDF-1 prepares to lift off from Earth, a great eruption takes place in the spatial coordinates behind the moon. Thousands of Zentradi cruisers begin to emerge from hyperspace, and in so doing, cause a great gravity wave disturbance in the area. This is the signal the three spies have been waiting for to begin their escape.
Let's move out!
Go!
right back. Return to Robotech, now!
Bridge, this is the radar room. We're picking up severe interspatial disturbances from an area right around the dark side of the moon. We're not sure, but it appears to be the fallout from a massive number of hyperspace fold operations.
Captain, come quick!
What's going on?
We don't know.
We're picking up gravity wave disturbances from the moon.
What? Is it the fold?
It's much more severe than that, sir. It appears to be multiple folds.
Are you able to estimate the number?
I'm trying.
Wait. Maybe they've come in peace this time. Right. Probably not.
Captain, we show an unidentified object flying right over the ship.
Lisa, do we have any fighters on patrol outside the ship?
No, sir.
Our monitors show a large alien vessel moving towards the Earth, and it appears to be on a rendezvous course with the object we've been tracking.
Move all Veritech groups to condition yellow at once.
Captain, I'm picking up another gravity disturbance, and this one's larger than before. The number of enemy ships I estimate is incredible. It's pretty close to a million.
Yes.
Well, I don't think it matters how many ships the enemy brings in.
But a million of them?
Up to now, we've never had to outmaneuver so many at once.
We beat them before, and we'll beat them again.
I'm almost certain headquarters must be aware of what's going on. Has there been any contact?
No, sir. There hasn't been a word.
That means we're completely isolated.
Huh? Why is that, sir?
I guess you might as well know. The commanders on Earth have decided the best way to protect the planet is to use the space fortress as a decoy to draw the aliens away. We are considered expendable.
As the alien commanders enter the staging area, they carefully position their vessels according to rank within the Zentradi fleet. Meanwhile, on his flagship, Commander Britai awaits the regeneration of his three spies, who are being returned to normal size before the presentation of their report.
Yes, we should be hearing from the cloning chamber.
Lord Britai, we have a transmission from Commander Azonian.
This should be interesting. Greetings, Commander. I shall not be resuming my command in this sector.
So I hear. You've assembled quite a fleet to deal with one small Robotech ship, Britai.
You noticed? That ship has caused quite a bit of trouble. Even you were beaten and humiliated.
My defeat was not humiliating. They had more powerful weapons.
That's exactly my point in assembling so many ships.
Sir.
Huh? I'll have to give you your assignment later.
Wait, I haven't given you my report yet.
Goodbye.
Britai!
More pressing matters require my attention.
Oh, well done, my lord. I believe they're waiting for us.
This report may turn the tide in our favor. Before we begin, I think it would be instructive to go over the Micronian artifacts you brought back. For instance, what's this?
They call that a piano, my lord.
Piano? What function does it serve?
It makes music, my lord. Music is when you put different sounds together for entertainment. It's really quite interesting when you get used to it. We came to enjoy it very...
Move on with your report.
As you wish, Commander. I can explain it most clearly, sir. We discovered the Micronians live a very different life from us. What we brought back only represents a small part of their society and its customs, what they refer to as their culture.
Go on.
My lord, this instrument operates on the concept of magnetic images, much like our own vid scanners, only they use it for a diversion called entertainment.
They're proficient at making repairs within their ship. Indeed, they rebuilt an entire population center on board using only salvaged materials. They adapt quickly to unfamiliar environments.
There are many Micronians besides soldiers on board the ship. In fact, they join together many times during the day and move about freely. And there's more to it than that, Commander. Males and females are together.
Oh, my.
No.
Yes.
As a matter of fact, it doesn't seem to be as bad as we thought.
We forced ourselves to adapt to the presence of the females around us, and we're unable to discover any negative side effects.
For the next several hours, the three spies unleash a flood of observations about life aboard the Battle Fortress. Britai is soon left speechless, until finally...
Enough! Stop it! My ears can't take any more! Their lifestyle is utterly confusing! What do you think?
Intriguing, my lord. Perhaps I should go there myself in order to confirm their observations.
There'd be no time to get a confirmation under the present circumstances. Lord Dulles is pushing for immediate action. All right, you can go.
My lord!
My lord!
Go in here, I want to ask you something.
I think it went real well.
But I kept some pieces in my pocket. Did you show them all you had?
No, I held out two.
Me too. I guess that means we all kept something.
Let's see what we've got.
I saved a load of stuff myself.
Just look at all these things we're carrying. Kanda, what have you got?
A monitor instrument and a magnetic player.
I brought along two of Min Mei's voice reproductions.
How about trading me one of those for something, huh?
What piece do you plan to trade?
I've got a Min Mei doll.
Okay.
The other guys would sure be impressed if they could see this stuff.
Yeah, we could get away with showing just a few guys, don't you think?
Let's do it.
Look at what we brought from the Robotech ship.
Here. And look at this.
And take a look at this.
Oh?
Here, you guys, eat these. They're good. The Micronians made those. They kept calling them cannons.
Amazing. It's completely different from our food. What is that? It looks like a Micronian, but what are those noises? Oh, did I hurt it?
No, dummy, it's called a Min Mei doll, and that noise is called singing.
You call that a Min Mei? It's incredible, I've never heard anything like it. Amazing. I think we should let some of the others hear this.
In a minute, be quiet, I can't hear when you're talking.
Word of the amazing artifact spreads quickly throughout Britai's ship, and shortly, Min Mei's name begins being whispered throughout every ship in the Zentradi fleet. Back on Earth, the Space Fortress is ready to lift off from the planet's surface, but first, Captain Global is faced with announcing the Defense Council's decision to the people on his ship. Word has passed here that an important broadcast is about to take place.
Quiet! Quiet, please! We're about to begin!
Camera 2, coming for a close-up. Camera 3, swing around for a wide-angle shot. Keep the chatter down, please! That's fine. Camera 2, here we go!
This is Captain Glovo speaking with a very important announcement to make to all of you aboard the SDF-1.
As many of you may already know, ever since we returned to Earth, I have appealed many times to the government and the Defense Force for permission to allow you to leave the ship and resettle wherever you might choose. Time and again, those appeals were turned
down. Stop!
To explain to you at this time. However, I always felt that progress was being made on those requests.
I'll just bet you anything, something
the
terrible has
the
happened.
Last few weeks.
My friends,
I am afraid that I have some very bad news to tell you. I have received word just a while ago that this ship and all of its passengers have been ordered to leave the Earth immediately.
What? Oh, good heavens.
I can't believe the government won't let us come back.
If we do not evacuate this planet, we've been warned that we might be attacked by elements of our own defense forces. This is an unthinkable possibility. We have therefore taken on supplies and are now prepared to leave the surface of the planet. I desperately need all of your cooperation in this moment of terrible responsibility.
We must all work for the day Earth will accept us back. Until then, we will survive as best we can. I give you my most humble apology.
Oh! Listen, everyone, the captain needs our support more than ever right now.
The captain is so upset about this all, I feel awful.
Look, I don't understand anything that has to do with politics, but I do know that the only way we'll survive this is to pull together.
She's right.
We've been on this ship for a long time, and I don't know about you, but I think of the SDF-1 as my home now.
Oh, that girl is absolutely right. This ship has been like a home to us.
Don't forget, we have almost everything here that we could ever have on Earth. Our own town and all the things that go along with it. We've all been through quite a bit, but look at how strong we've become because of it. I have more friends here than I ever did on Earth. You've been like a big family to me. Someday we'll come back to Earth. We'll never give up hope. But for now, I'm proud to be a citizen of Macross City in this ship.
I believe it's the best speech I've ever heard someone make.
Well, inspired me. I'm proud to shake the hand of another citizen of Macross City.
Everybody take their positions. We're going to move out immediately. All systems online. Let's have a status report.
Control module shows full power base throughout the system. Thrusters engaged.
All gravity ports open.
Prepare to fire reflex engines now.
Firing.
No matter where we go in space or how long it takes, our hearts will always be tied to the Earth. So to help us express our feelings at this moment, I'd like to perform a song for you and dedicate it to the Earth we love.
Captain, I respect your honesty. We all know you did the best you could.
And I'm here now singing. All bells are ringing. My dream has finally come true.
the next episode of Robotech, the spotlight is on Min Mei as she prepares for the premiere of her first motion picture. Huge lines form around the theater, and even Rick and Lisa find time to catch a glimpse of a rising star. Don't miss A New Dawn, the next chapter in the amazing story of Robotech.